Welcome back. Today we're joined by Tom Winslow from Goldfinch Winslow Attorneys at Law. Thank you for joining us
today. Thank you for having
me. Because today we're going to get a legal perspective on something that's been in the news, and that is the Kentucky Derby.
Okay.
Yes, it happened a weekend or so ago, but the fact that the winner, Medina Spirit, yes, thank you, was found to not pass a drug test.
Or the not-so winner.
Yes, the not-so winner. This has implications.
It does. I mean, if you think about it, right, so people go and buy tickets, right? Kentucky Derby is a race, but really, what is it? It's gambling, right? And you go and buy a ticket with an explanation that you're going to have a winner, and you're going to be able to cash in your ticket. Well, what happens? Medina Spirit wins, they cash in their ticket, they get paid. Well, what about the people now that say, hey, my horse actually won,
right?
And so there's so many implications in this that's fascinating within the law. You got the breach of contract, right? There was an agreement that people were going to get paid for winning or losing. Well, some people got paid for not winning now.
Right.
Some people are not going to get paid when their horse did win, right? So you get this breach of contract, you got this fraud situation.
That's right.
Maybe a conspiracy situation. So many implications in the law based upon the situation that could lead to class action. Could lead him to a lawsuit against the trainer and for maybe even the horse track. You don't know.
Yeah, and this could be that he gets cleared. There's all sort of conspiracy theories out there as to why this horse didn't pass.
Yes.
It's a drug test. And also, one thing I was curious about from the betting perspective, once the thing is over and it's done, it really is done. If you had the person who was second to win, You still lose.
It's like your ticket, right? You go to a baseball field and you hear about people getting hit with baseballs or bats, right? Those tickets say you can't claim, you can't come back later. Same thing with gambling, right? Those tickets say that's it. You can't come back now a week later and say, no, my horse really won. Those tickets have implications just like that contract. It's amazing to think about it.
Yeah, and so that's a real fun sort of perspective on that. But in real life, there's fraud and things like that as well. So if someone feels like they've had something against them, or maybe they were in a pool and they picked the runner-up and not Medina Spirits, and they want to see about if they need to talk to their brother-in-law about getting their money back, how do they get in contact with you?
You can give us a call, 843-357-9301, goldfinchwinslow.com.